to the SST classroom. Now, in the last video, we discussed about the new chapter, that is India Physical and Political Behavior. I explained you about the introduction of the chapter. Hope you have read the textbook and you have to underline the new words. So, what introduction of the chapter we start? We start about that India is bounded by Indian Ocean in the south, Arabian Sea in the west, and Bay of Bengal in the east. I explain you about that India is vast country and it is the seventh largest country in the world. Let us discuss about India, its six physical divisions. I know that we have learned the six physical divisions. Tell me now, which is the number one physical division? That is Northern Mountain. And the number two, Northern Plain. Number three, the Great Indian Desert. Number four, the Southern Plateau. Number fifth, the Coastal Plain. Number six, what is the number six? The Island Region. So what I told that all this we are going to discuss in the next video. So today we are going to discuss about the Northern Mountain and Northern Plain. Now my dear children, you are sitting at home and you are very tired. You are not getting in vacation also. You didn't step out from your home because of coronavirus. So my dear children, today we will go to the Northern Mountain. Are you ready? Want to come to the Northern Mountain? Come on. Come. Now, see, this Northern Mountain, this is the first physical division, first physical division of India. Northern Mountain, it includes Himalaya and Karakoram range. As think that you went to the Northern Mountain. Now, just see what it includes. It includes Himalaya and Karakoram range. Now the Himalayan range is the highest range in the world. It stretches from very stretch, Jammu and Kashmir in the Himachal Pradesh in the east. My dear children, you are going to some place, you should know about that place. Okay? So now there are many peaks in this mountain range. You know what is peak? The pointing part. You can see here this is the mountain and the pointing part of the mountain is known as peak. So here you will see many peaks. There are many peaks in this Himalaya range. Now the peak of Himalayan range, this Himalayan range, the peak of Himalayan range, it is covered by snow. You know snow, it is the ice, so it is covered by snow throughout the year. In my children, and here the Mount Everest, you know about the Mount Everest, it is the highest peak in the world, and where it is highest peak in the world, and it is in Nepal, and what is it height? 8850. Okay, so Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world. Now later, what we discuss about the Northern Mountain, that the discuss about the Northern, it share the boundary between India and China. Hope you have understood about the Northern Plain, Northern Mountain. So what you have seen in the Northern Mountain, you see the Himalaya and Karakoram range, and then we learn about that Himalayan range is the highest peak in the world. Then we discuss that it stretch from where it stretch? Stretch from Jammu and Kashmir in the west, Arunachal Pradesh in the east. Then we discuss that there are many peaks. You know what is peak? The pointed part of the mountain. So here you will see many peaks in the mountain, and then this peak is covered by snow throughout the year. And here the Mount Everest is the highest peak in the world, and it is in Nepal, and what is its height? It is 8850 meter. And then I explain you that the the northern mountain it share the boundary between India and China. Hope till here you have understood about the northern mountain. Now we'll go to the second division. Come on. Now let's go to the second division, that is northern plain. Now northern plain, it is lie to the south of northern mountain. You see the northern mountain, the south of that is the northern plain, and it occupies the greater part of North India. It also stretches from Punjab to Assam, and this plain is also known as Gangetic Plain because of many rivers. Here you can see the river that lies in this plain, that is Ganga, Ravi, Satluj, Indus, Brahmaputra, etc. Got it, my children? So because of this river, because of all this river which lies in the northern plain, that place makes the land very fertile. You know why it's made very fertile? Because of the river. And in the fertile land, it is very easy to grow. So mostly the people of northern plain, they are doing the agriculture activities over there. Because why? Because the land is very fertile. And in fertile land, it is very easy to grow crop. Hope here you have understood about the northern plains, that northern plains, it is the south of northern mountain, and it occupies a great part of North India. Okay, and this place is also known as Gangetic Plain because of the rivers. And later we discuss about their people. Mostly here they are doing the agriculture because of the fertile land. Why this land makes very fertile? Because of all the perennial river which is there in the northern plain. Hope till here you have understood about the northern mountain and northern plain. In the next video, we will learn the next third division, that is the Great Indian Desert. Now what you have to do? You have to read the textbook, you have to underline the important points, and also you have to underline the new words. Thank you. Have a nice day.